Welcome, dear students. Today we are going to discuss how to determine partition coefficient of benzoic acid in benzene and water. Aim of today's practical: to determine partition coefficient of benzoic acid in benzene and water. Then requirements to perform this practical: first, chemicals, benzoic acid, distilled water, benzene, 0.1 normal NaOH, 0.01 normal NaOH, and phenolphthalein indicator. Then apparatus required to perform this experiment: separating funnel, reagent bottle, then beakers, burette stand, burette and conical flask, then electronic weighing balance. Now we'll see what exactly the partition coefficient, what exactly the distribution law. So if you take two immiscible solvents A and B in a beaker, they form a separate layer because they are immiscible with each other. When a solute X, which is soluble in both solvents, is added, it gets distributed or partitioned between them. Molecules of X passes from solvent A to B and from solvent B to A, and finally a dynamic equilibrium is set up. At equilibrium condition, the rate at which molecules of X passes from one solvent to other is balanced. The distribution or partition of solute between immiscible liquid is known as Nernst distribution law. So if you observe this diagram, these are the two separate liquids. Both are immiscible with each other. And when you add your solute in these immiscible solvents, this solute get distributed into these two different solvents. Then at equilibrium condition, the concentration of X, that is solute, in solvent A divided by concentration of solute X in a B, so this X is distributed into the solvent A and B, and the ratio of concentration of this X into the solvent A and B is nothing but distribution constant or partition coefficient of that solute. Then statement of Nernst distribution law: if a solute X distributes itself between two immiscible solvents, that is A and B, at a constant temperature, and X is in the same molecular condition in both solvents, so ratio of this concentration into A and B will give you value, that is Nernst distribution or partition coefficient of that drug. If C1 denotes concentration of solute in the solvent A and C2 the concentration of solute into the solvent B, then Nernst distribution law can be expressed as C1 divided by C2 is equal to KD. The constant KD is called the distribution coefficient or partition coefficient or distribution ratio. So these are the different terms for the partition coefficient. Then solubility and distribution law: when a solute is shaken with two immiscible solvents at equilibrium, both the solvents are saturated with solute. And since solubility also represents concentration, we can write the distribution law as C1 divided by C2 is equal to S1 divided by S2 is equal to KD. Means when your both solvents get saturated with solute, these solvents define solubility of that solute into the particular solvent. Then S1 and S2 are the solubilities of that solute into the solvents. Hence, knowing the value of distribution coefficient and solubility of solute in one of the solvent, the solubility of solute in the second solvent can be calculated. Then explanation for this distribution law. Suppose the R1 is a rate at which this X solute passes from solvent A to B, and it is proportional to its concentration, that is C1. And R2 is a rate at which your X molecules or solutes pass from solvent B to A, and it is proportional to the C2 into the solvent B. And also at equilibrium, rate of migration of solute from one solvent to other is equal. This is a Nernst distribution equation. Since K1 and K2 are a constant at the same temperature, and distribution coefficient Kd is also constant if temperature is fixed. So this is the solvent A, solvent B, and distribution of solute is there into these two solvent. When your solute is moving from solvent A to B, this is R1 rate, and it is directly proportional to the C1 concentration. So we can write it as R1 is equal to K1 into C1. Then similarly, R2 is directly proportional to C2. Then R2 is equal to K2 into C2. But at equilibrium condition, rate of transfer of molecule from A to B and B to A is equal. That's why R1 is equal to R2. So we can put a value of R1 into this equation, K1 into C1, and R2, that is K2 into C2. So our equation will become C1 upon C2 is equal to K2 upon K1 is equal to Kd. Then applications of this partition coefficient. Solubility of drug in water and other solvent can be predicted. Then extraction of drug from biological fluid such as blood, tissue and urine can be obtained sufficiently. Then effective concentration of preservative can be predicted for the storage of emulsion and other dosage form. Then drug absorption in vivo can be predicted by using an octanol and water partitioning system, mimic the lipid membrane and water system found in the body. Then release drug from ointment and cream can be predicted. In the context of pharmacodynamic, the hydrophobic effect of major driving force for binding the drugs to the receptor target, it is advisable to make the drug as a hydrophilic as possible while it still retain adequate binding affinity to the therapeutic protein target. Now, benzoic acid, when added to which benzene and water is distribute between the benzene and water, then benzoic acid exists as an associated molecule into the benzene and it as an individual molecule into the aqueous phase. Means in organic phase, it is associated with benzene, and in aqueous phase, individual molecule is distributed into the aqueous phase. And partition law is applicable to solute species, common to both phases. Situation is mathematically expressed as K is equal to under root C organic divided by C aqueous, where N is the number of benzoic acid molecules associated in a benzene and it form dimer, that's why value of N will become 2. Now we'll see procedure. First of all, we require to prepare 110 ml saturated solution of benzoic acid into the benzene and use this solution as a stock solution. Then prepare a following mixtures of four separate reagent bottle and label them as a A, B, C, D. So this is composition of each bottle. In bottle A, you have to take 50 ml distilled water, 40 ml stock solution, and 10 ml benzene. Stock solution that is prepared into the benzene. Then in bottle B, 50 ml distilled water, 30 ml stock solution, and 20 ml benzene. For the bottle C, 50 ml distilled water, 20 ml stock solution, and 30 ml benzene. And for bottle D, 50 ml distilled water, 10 ml stock solution, and 40 ml benzene. Then place a stopper on each bottle and shake them vigorously for 30 minutes. That's why what happened? There is a good distribution of your drug or benzoic acid into the benzene and water. Then transfer this mixture into the separating funnel labeled as A, B, C, D and allow them to stand for 10 minutes to separate the layers. Then collect organic and aqueous layer in a dry beaker. So what you have to do? You have to shake it vigorously, then you have to transfer it into the separating funnel, and then the separating funnel is also labeled as the A, B, C, D. And allow it to remain as it is for the 10 minutes so there is a proper separation of organic and aqueous layer. Then you have to separate out this organic layer and aqueous layer. Then pipette out 10 ml titrate, 10 ml of contained, and titrate against sodium hydroxide solution using 2 to 3 drops of indicator. So your aqueous layer you have to titrate against the 0.01 normal sodium hydroxide. Then endpoint is detected as pink color. Let the title reading will be your V aqueous value. When you titrate your aqueous layer with sodium hydroxide, that is 0.01 normal, then it gives you burette reading, and that burette reading will be your V aqueous value. Similarly, pipette out 10 ml organic layer and transfer to the conical flask with the help of dry pipette, and this solution is titrated against 0.1 normal sodium hydroxide solution using phenolphthalein as an indicator, and the endpoint is detected are appearance of pink color, and this reading will be your burette reading will be your V organic value. So repeat the step 6 and 7 for all remaining samples. So similarly, you have to pipette out organic layer and aqueous layer from B, C, and D separating funnel and titrate it and note down the burette reading.
How to determine partition coefficient of benzoic acid in benzene and water? First of all, we'll see which glassware is required to perform the experiment. We'll require burette stand, then burette, then tripod stand, measuring cylinder, then reagent bottle, then separating funnel, then conical flask, beaker, pipette, rubber bulb, and glass rod. Then chemicals required to perform this practical: benzoic acid, then distilled water, then benzene, 0.1 normal NaOH, then 0.01 normal NaOH, and phenolphthalein indicator. Now I am going to prepare a saturated solution of this benzoic acid and with the benzene. Now first of all, I am taking 110 ml of benzene. Then slowly, slowly, I am going to add this benzoic acid into this benzene. Mix it properly with help of glass rod and add further amount of benzoic acid. So likewise, you have to prepare saturated solution of benzoic acid into the benzene. Now I am ready with my saturated solution. So how can we come to know that it is saturated? When you add benzoic acid in this benzene, after vigorous shaking, it remains as it is. So this excess solid will come to know that there is a completion of saturation process of solvent and our saturated solution of benzoic acid is ready to use. Here I have taken 4 reagent bottles and these bottles are labeled as A, B, C and D. Now in each bottle I am going to take a distilled water 50 ml. So in all 4 bottles, I am taking 50 ml distilled water. In all 4 bottles, now I am going to add this stock solution of benzoic acid which is prepared into the benzene. Now in first bottle, I am adding 40 ml of this stock solution. Then into bottle B, I am going to add 30 ml. Then into the bottle C, I am adding 20 ml stock solution. And into bottle B, I'm adding 10 ml stock solution. Now, third thing is required to add in these all 4 bottles, that is benzene. So first quarter, I'm adding 10 ml of benzene. Then 20 ml. I'm adding into the bottle B. Then 30 ml. Bottle D, I am adding 40 ml benzene. So I am ready with my four bottles. I am going to shake it. Shake this bottle vigorously. So distribution of benzoic acid will be there into the water as well as into the benzene. Likewise, you have to shake this bottle, C and D also. Likewise, you have to shake this bottle 30 minutes. So there will be proper distribution of benzoic acid into the benzene and water. So almost I have completed 30 minutes. Now I am going to transfer it into the separating funnel. Now this reagents which are present into the reagent bottle, I have transferred into this separating funnel. And the separating funnels are also labeled as A, B, C and D. Now when you transfer this all content into the reagent bottle into the separating funnel, there is a separation of two layers. You allow to keep it for the 10 minutes and after 10 minutes, you will get two separate layers, okay? Bottom layer is aqueous layer and upper layer is your organic layer. So by using this separating funnel, easily you can separate out organic as well as aqueous layer. With this knob, you can separate out aqueous layer and from the upper side, you can remove organic layer. If you observe all of this separating funnel, you will get two layers. Okay, upper layer is organic and lower is aqueous layer. Now we are going to titrate it. Now I am going to separate this aqueous layer. If you observe it, when I move this knob, slowly, slowly, aqueous layer is transferring to the deeper. So likewise, you have to separate out this organic layer. Now from this first separating funnel, organic layer is separated out. separating the aqueous layer from B, separating phoneme. So likewise, you can separate the aqueous layer from this separating phoneme C and P. If you observe this separating funnel, there is no more aqueous layer into this separating funnel. Okay, you will get a single homogeneous layer, that is aqueous layer. Now, complete aqueous layer I have separated out from this B. Now, similarly, I am going to separate aqueous layer from this C and D conical, sorry, separating funnel. Now from all of these four separating funnel, I have separated this aqueous layer, and if you observe it, only organic layer is remaining into this separating funnel A, B, C and D. No aqueous layer is there into this separating funnel. Now I am going to take a 10 ml of this aqueous layer which is separated from A separating funnel. Then I am going to titrate it against 0.1 normal, 0.01 normal NaOH by using phenolphthalein as an indicator. And 3 drops of phenolphthalein. Then titrate it. With 0.01 normal NaOH. Check your conical glass continuously, so distribution of the NaOH should be there. Now it is converted into the light pink color. And my duration trading is 23. So similarly, you have to take this aqueous layer from this B, C and D, and you have to titrate it against the point not one normal and average by using phenolphthalein as an indicator. Now I am going to titrate organic layer. Now I am going to take for this organic layer 10 mm. And I am going to titrate it against 0.1 normal NaOH by using phenolphthalein indicator. Slowly you have to add NaOH into this conical glass. Then it is distributed between solution. Now it is converted into the light pink color. Our color solution is converted into the light pink color. And my duration is, okay, it is converted into the pink color and duration is 22.1. To separate out organic layer from the separating phenol B, C and D and titrate it against 0.1 normal NaOH.
Now we'll see observation table. So these are the readings. V organic, these are the readings of your organic layer of bottle A, B, C and D. While this V aqueous, readings of your aqueous layer of bottle A, B, C and D. So both of these columns are burette reading of your organic layer and aqueous layer. Then you require to calculate this an organic and an aqueous value. How to calculate it? We'll see. First of all, we'll see what exactly the V organic. volume of 0.1 normal sodium hydroxide per 10 ml of organic layer required to neutralize. Then we aqueous volume of 0.01 normal sodium hydroxide for 10 ml of your aqueous layer. Then N organic is normality of organic layer. N aqueous is normality of your aqueous layer. Then under root C organic is concentration of benzoic acid in organic layer, and C aqueous concentration of benzoic acid into the aqueous layer, and K is the partition coefficient value of benzoic acid into the benzene and water. Then we'll see how to calculate it. First of all, we'll calculate for the aqueous layer. Now concentration of benzoic acid into the bottle A, its normality referred as the N aqueous. So by using this equation N1V1 is equal to N2V2, we can calculate the normality. So instead of V2, you can put your burette reading, then you will get normality of benzoic acid into the bottle A. Similarly, concentration of benzoic acid in aqueous layer in moles per liter can be calculated by using the formula 0.01 into burette reading into 122 divided by 10. Then final answer will have unit moles per liter. Now we'll see how to calculate by taking a first reading. So N1V1 is equal to N2V2. So our first burette reading was 23. So normality of benzoic acid, that is N aqueous value, is 0.023 normal. Now we'll convert it into the moles per liter by using second formula, that is 0.01 into V2, that is 23 into 122 divided by 10. So answer is 2.806 moles per liter. So this is C aqueous value for bottle A. Similarly, you have to calculate for B, C and D bottles. Then calculation for the organic layer. Concentration of benzoic acid into the bottle A, that is N organic value, you can calculate by using equation N1V1 is equal to N2V2. Here 0.1 is taken, that is strength of your NaOH. This N1V1 means normality of your benzoic acid into volume of your benzoic acid into normality of your NaOH and volume of your NaOH. Now volume of NaOH will be your burette reading. So 0.1 normality of NaOH into burette reading divided by 10 means 10 ml organic layer we have taken for the titration. That's why V1 value will become 10. And we want to calculate this N1 value. So just you have to put your readings in this equation and you will get the N1 value. Now we want to convert it into the moles per liter. So similarly as that of your aqueous concentration, you require to use formula 0.1 into V2, that is burette reading, into 122 divided by 10. Will give you moles per liter amount of your benzoic acid. Now for organic layer, we'll take example of one reading. Our first reading is 22.1. So instead of this V2 value, that is your burette reading, you have to put, and strength of NaOH is 0.1, and volume of acid we have taken for the titration, that is 10 ml. So value of N1 become 0.221 normal. Then concentration of benzoic acid in aqueous layer, that is a C organic value, in moles per liter we can calculate by using this formula, and our burette reading is 22.1, and after calculating answer is 26.96 moles per liter. Then we require to take under root of this answer, that is 5.19. After this, you require to calculate partition coefficient, that is K is equal to C aqueous divided by under root C organic. So value of our C aqueous is 2.8606, and under root C organic value, that is 5.19. And final value of K is 0.5406. So similarly, you have to calculate this K value for B, C and D. So in a table, I have calculated all the values of K. Now you required to take an average of these all K values obtained from bottle A, B, C and D. So bottle A, K value 0.5406, bottle B 0.400, then bottle C 0.200 and bottle D 0.153 divided by 4. Then we'll get average value of partition coefficient and it is 0.3234. Then result, the partition coefficient of benzoic acid in benzene and water was found to be 0.3234. Now we'll see questions that most probably asked for the synopsis and viva. First question, what is phase? A homogeneous, physically distinct portion of a system that is separated from other portion of the system by bounding surface. For example, liquid water and water vapor, two phases, and liquid water, water vapor and solid ice is having a three phases. Then second question, enlist methods of determination of partition coefficient. First method, substitution method, and second method, that is graphical method. Then third question, what is partition coefficient? It is a ratio of concentration of solute in two immiscible or slightly miscible liquid or in two solid when it is in equilibrium across the interface between them. Why octanol is used to determine partition coefficient? The partition coefficient is used to provide a picture of how a drug distributes itself between organic and aqueous phases of body. Since our blood and fluids are aqueous, the protein and fats that the drug penetrates through are attached to are organic. So basically, octanol is a simple and accurate model for the body's organic phase. That's why octanol water system is used to determine partition coefficient of your drug during pre-formulation studies. Then next question, what is Nernst distribution law or state Nernst distribution law? If a solute X is distributing into these two different solvents, that is A and B, then its concentration into the A and B is giving a value, that is KD, and this value is nothing but your partition coefficient value. Okay, we can write it as C1 upon C2, that is concentration of X into the A, and C2, that is concentration of X into the B. So its ratio is distribution of your drug into the, or partition of your drug into the different solvents. Then next question, what are the applications of partition coefficients? First application, solubility of drug in water and other solvent can be predicted by using partition coefficient. Then extraction of drug from biological fluid like blood, tissue and urine, and can be obtained sufficiently. Then effective concentration of preservative can be predicted for the storage of emulsion and other dosage form. Then drug absorption in vivo can be predicted. Then an octanol and water system is used to determine partition coefficient of your drug. Then release of drug from the ointments and creams can be predicted. In a context of pharmacodynamic, the hydrophobic effect is a major driving force for the binding of drug to their receptor targets. And it is advisable to make your drug hydrophilic as possible while it still retain adequate binding affinity to the therapeutic protein target. And then what are the advantages of Schenck flask method? First advantage, that is most accurate method, then accurate for broadest range of solute like neutral to charged compounds, then simple and lab operative process. So these are the advantages of your Schenck flask method. This is all about partition coefficient of your benzoic acid into the benzene and water. Thank you.